Earth is literally on fire with global warming, nuclear proliferation, overpopulation, ocean acidification, and several other self-induced hazards. Evolution has already wiped out 99.9% of all life forms. So at some point, humanity might have to abandon Earth or perish with it. Our big chance would be to find a new habitable planet that we can call home. And for scientists and innovators like Elon Musk, that potential new home is the red planet that sits 34 million miles away from Earth. In today's video, we'll be walking you through on how to colonize Mars. So without further delay, let's get right into it. In about 4 billion years, the temperature on the surface of the Earth could rise to as much as 462 degrees Celsius, making human life impossible on our planet. That sounds like a pretty long time from now, even if we measure it on a cosmic scale. But there are other risks that could literally wipe out human existence before this time frame. There's a chance we could get hit by a massive asteroid as well. Although NASA says that this happens only once every 100 million years. Currently, the 1950 DA, the largest asteroid that has the biggest chance of wiping us out, is not expected to arrive until March 16th, 2880. But we already know that it's coming. With all these potential doomsday scenarios lurking, it's clear that we're in a race against time to find other livable planets. But unfortunately, our options are limited. A great alternative would be to find livable exoplanets. NASA already has a program that's dedicated to this purpose. And so far, over 4,000 exoplanets have been discovered, but none of them have shown signs of intelligent life. And most of them are billions of light years away from the Earth. And this is why scientists are rooting for Mars as the planet that will save us from going extinct. The atmosphere on Mars is about 100 times thinner than Earth's atmosphere, and most of it is made of carbon dioxide. There's a tiny bit of oxygen as well, but it's not enough to support human existence. However, the good thing is we can make as much oxygen as we want when we get there. In fact, a few weeks ago, NASA's Perseverance rover broke down molecules of carbon dioxide to make breathable oxygen. That's enough to sustain human life for 10 minutes. Now that we've affirmed that Mars is a habitable planet, it would be nice to know how we can build a sustainable colony there. To start with, there are four major issues that must be addressed if we are to colonize Mars. The first is transportation. Traveling around space isn't exactly the same as flying to your favorite holiday destination. This might sound ridiculous considering the fact that on average it only takes 2 minutes and 30 seconds for a rocket to cross the Kármán line into orbit. But then, the trip to Mars is a lot more technical. The amount of time needed to travel to Mars depends on the type of spacecraft you travel in, and more importantly, when you decide to make the trip. This is because Earth and Mars orbit around the Sun. Therefore, the distance between them is constantly changing. So to ensure a smooth sail, astronauts have to find the right cosmic alignment between both planets. Basically, this is when both planets are nearest to themselves in orbit. But even that is relative. The closest distance ever recorded between Earth and Mars was 33.9 million miles in 2003. But we won't get that close to the red planet again until 2287. With that said, a one-way trip from Earth to Mars would take between 7 to 9 months. Once on Mars, astronauts would have to manufacture rocket fuel to transport back to Earth, as carrying anything extra would be a mission impossible. Besides that, getting 1 kilogram of load to Mars can cost up to $200,000. And according to NASA, 25 tons of oxygen would be required to transport 4 astronauts back from Mars. That brings us to our next talking point, which is self-sufficiency. Self-sufficiency is pivotal to our chances of living permanently on Mars. As we mentioned earlier, moving things between Earth and Mars will not come cheap. So basically, a large chunk of what we'll need on Mars must be produced on Mars, from oxygen and food to water and power. Tesla CEO Elon Musk believes that humans must shift around 1 million tons of cargo to Mars before we'll be able to create a self-sustaining city. We imagine that this cargo will contain all the necessary gadgets needed to produce the necessary amenities to sustain human existence. The experiment carried out by the Perseverance rover gives us hope about generating oxygen, power, and water. But producing food might be much more difficult. A group of scientists at the Utah Research Station are working round the clock to find a breakthrough in this regard. However, we can be hopeful, as at this very moment, potatoes are successfully growing on the moon. But if we want to make our stand in the long run, solving governance is a must. Governance is a tricky issue even here on Earth, and this could be one of the most challenging issues in our attempts to colonize Mars. Charles Cockle, an astrobiologist from the University of Edinburgh, sums it up nicely. "A space colony is a tyranny-prone environment," Charles said. "If somebody gets control of oxygen, they could very well have control over the whole population and threaten dire consequences in return for extraordinary levels of power. It is believed that a hierarchy command system will be adopted in the first few years of colonization. But as the planet continues to develop, the citizens of Mars will certainly need to elect presidents, governors, and representatives. Another big problem we must solve is reproduction. To sustain our existence and ensure long-term survival on the Martian planet, we must kickstart and maintain a reproduction cycle." Cameron Smith, an anthropologist at Portland State University in Oregon, believes that a population of 2,000 people would be sufficient to do this. "At some point, the Mars base breaks out of becoming a base and becomes an actual village," Smith said. "A real society with real people, living real lives, with children in school and community orchestras." Yet, however, getting there, 2,000 people, is only an imagination at this point. So who are the pioneers? Gone are the days when space exploration and colonization was left for the government organizations like NASA, ESA, and others. Nowadays, it has become the long-life dream of established business tycoons like Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, and Richard Branson. Among these three billionaires, Elon Musk is the odd one out because he is yet to visit space. However, Musk has taken it upon himself to drag humanity to Mars, and he's committing the full scale of his wealth and resources to the project through his aerospace company, SpaceX. "We don't want to be one of those single planet species. We want to be a multi-planet species," the tech billionaire said. Elon Musk believes that the first human could land on Mars by 2029, and the colonization should be in full effect by 2050. The SpaceX boss also added there's a chance that he would travel to Mars at some point in his lifetime, and even said he might die there. Nonetheless, NASA has two observational robots on Mars already, and there are plans to send more. So we cannot rule out the prospect of a public-private partnership leading us to Mars as well. But how much would it cost to colonize Mars? Elon Musk estimates the established human presence on Mars would cost between $100 billion and $10 trillion. Regardless of where the price falls, one thing is certain: colonizing Mars will not come cheap, and it is not guaranteed to return profit. And according to the millionaire, many will die at the first runs. Colonizing Mars is not in any way an easy task, but for Musk, NASA, and many cosmic scientists, the lure of making humans a multi-planetary species is too tempting to ignore.